I say, not themselves experiencing unpleasantness or injustice. And since they are able to enjoy life, they refuse to concern themselves with the worries and troubles under which others
have gone a long way since the dark days of life was.
And still,
we are now weathering world's pressures better than any other country in the world.
There are all sorts of
Thank you. this dictatorial act, they deprived the electors of their rights, and they also demonstrated that when the nation took their personal freedom, they were freedom to themselves or for their friends.
Thank you. I can't get by on odd jobs every few weeks.
I don't want you to go away. There must be something here you can do.
I can't get by, let alone save anything.
I don't understand it, Tom. You've got a trade.
Trade? What good's a carpenter if nothing's being built?
Well, where would you go? Where would it be any better?
I thought maybe Wellington.
Oh! Jimmy, and that's Miriam and Jude.
I'm Tom.
Hello, Tom.
A long way from home, Tom. What do you do?
I'm a carpenter.
For what it's worth.
Carpenter, eh?
Bit different on the doll, mate.
Oh, I'm not on the doll.
Your turn will come.
Your turn will come.
I've worked 40 years
in a factory.
I did everything I was told. But one day the boss took his watch out and he said,
"My dear man, you're too old. See him, see him, and maybe nothing more. See him, see him, see him, and maybe nothing more.
I fought overseas for my country. I went there to do or to die. I thought that my country would have backed me. But this was my country's reply.
Well, I'm not quite settled in at the moment, but yeah.
Nowhere to sleep, nowhere to wait. Even tall buildings of a state. Churches are closed against the destitute. Cannon and war taking priestly loot. God would not be pleased, says the preacher. Thank you.
home. Winter's hit us with a bang. I don't feel as if we've had a summer at all. Mum's chest bad again. I hope it's not as cold as this in the Windy City, and that the boarding house is nice and warm. Don't be too upset if you have to apply for relief. If you've got to, you've got to. They must know you'd work if you could. Are you sure it's all right for me to write to you, care of the post office? I've been doing some cleaning for some people in Kashmir, but that stops next week. They're off for a jaunt, as they put it. Abroad. Nice to be some people. It makes me mad.
Where shall I go this winter?
Where shall we follow the sun?
Where shall I go this winter?
Where does our budget run?
The Rhine,
the river,
Bali,
Andorra,
Mallorca, Singapore. Tales flow free. Where it's place to find it, that discriminating gold
shall we go?
Give me
then. Don't say I said so, but I doubt that faith had much to do with it. It's more likely the warmer weather. Things are up and down here, but it still looks like I'll be home for Christmas. Oh, I can't wait to see him. I just can't wait. January 20th, 1931. I'm sorry I didn't let you know about moving further north. It all happened a bit sudden. My mate Frank heard about these jobs in Auckland, so we jumped a train. But it's no better than Wellington. It's just the same, on a bigger scale. At least the winter shouldn't be so bad. I thought I could make a bit of dough before Christmas, you see. I'm sorry I didn't get home. Two Christmases. It doesn't seem that long. Yes, it does. Everything's...
I ask for
special. I felt so helpless here. 239 people dead. I keep meeting people who've lost relatives and friends. But it's great the way the whole country's pitched in. Tom's not impressed, of course. He says, give Forbes and Coates an earthquake, and train loads of food and clothing miraculously appear. Give them a nationwide economic disaster, and they do nothing. I don't know. And now they've got this idea for a cheer up week. As if that will do anything. As if all we have to do is buck up and everything will be all right. Tell Doug that I'm pleased that he's doing so well on the council, but that I don't agree that people bring about their own misfortunes.
Yeah.
at these rocks?
Over there.
Why?
Why?
What do you mean, why?
Just shoot them.
And we've only...
What do you care?
It's work, isn't it?
Jeez, you blokes, you shift more dirt with your boots than you do with a shovel. Now get on with it.
Yeah.
I said get on with it.
Yeah, yeah.
Josie, it just got worse and worse. Robin, you wake your guts out to get out of that bloody harness on the next train home, only to lose it all at cards. It's like I've spent the last 5 years in a well. Up to the tonsils in the water. And then when they put off the elections, I'm over here.
Tom.
Thank you.
pneumonia, but
double pneumonia! Oh, how is your mum?
Much better now that she's got something to look forward to.
Oh,
Cheryl's coming, by the way, but not Doug. Oh,
just as well, we probably come to blows.
With his views, he makes even Hitler look like a moderate.
Doug and Adolf, the goose-step twins! Oh, I'm off to a meeting.
Labour Party.
I don't know what I'll do if Bulbs and Coates get back in.
Commit murder, probably.
Do you want to come?
I'd love to. But Mum needs me, and the work at 6 a.m.
I don't know what's worse. Being out of work like me, or having to sew sugar bags in the slave factory. You should organise.
Yes, I know, but they only sack people who speak out.
Yeah. Well, it'll be different after the revolution.
Yeah.
In the meantime, a change of government will just have to do.
With your parents.
I suppose I'll have to.
Till after the wedding.
Bye.
Bye. Dear Cheryl, I'm so excited. Only a few months and I'll see you again. It's been a long time. I'm sorry Doug can't make it, but...
Jam to radio, it's just a small mistake.
Come on for us!
Come for us!
Come for us!
Act it, man! Say no longer, hey!
Come for us!
Come for us! Come for us!
In the election!
Only for a year!
And since your letters are
raw!
Rioting!
now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Just begun.
to your own devices with a dying mother and a three-year-old who can't even remember what his dad looked like. But I remember. I remember his endless battle for equality and justice. I remember the letters he wrote and the promises he made. I remember the child on his knee and the laughter and the hope. And then he went overseas and died in a war that wasn't even his. And so I remember one thing more. The fight that's still to come.
Thank you.